for my answer, thank you. For though we have heard the vows which have been shared by Will and Chris, once spoken and carried away on the wind, therefore these rings are a visible symbol of the promises made here tonight. May these rings be a reminder of the commitment that you have made today, and as a testimony to all the world of your devotion to one another. So I believe you would take Chris's ring. You would place it on his wedding finger.
Chris, with this ring, I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
And all the love in it.
And all the love in it.
I have no greater gift to give.
I have no greater gift to give.
Chris and Will have chosen to celebrate communion at this wedding service. And communion is the gift that was offered to the early believers as a way of remembering Jesus. It was a way in which they would be able to, whenever they gathered together, to remember the values that he taught them. Values of grace, of love, hope. Values that would unite rather than divide. Values that, regardless of our faith traditions, we can call sacred, and they were taught to us by this one called Jesus. On the night that he was to be taken from his friends, he gathered in an upper room. It was to celebrate the Jewish feast called Passover, Messiah. And in the Jewish celebration of Passover, there were many traditions, including the breaking of bread, and the pouring of wine. And at the very beginning of the meal, a piece of bread would be taken, it was called matzah, and it would be broken in half. And the head of the household would take half of the piece of matzah and hide it. It was called the afikome, which means the dessert, the best that's always meant to last. And at the end of the seder, the children would run around the house and they would find the afikomen and bring it back to the head of the household, and there would be a great celebration. It was a symbol that they had found what they had lost. It's that bread that we in the Christian church believe that we take at this meal. That Jesus took that bread, gave you thanks and praise, blessed it, and then he opened it. He opened it like he opened his life before him. And he said to them, take and eat of this. This is the dessert. This is the best of the best. This is what's left for you. Not the leftovers, but the first fruits. So take and eat of this as often as you shall do so to remember me. On the table were also many glasses of wine, and at the very beginning of the Passover, the head of the household would take one cup. It was called the cup of Elijah. They would mark that cup at the very top of where the wine settled. And at the end of the meal, the head of the household would return to that cup to see if anything had been drunk from it. You see, they believed that if anything had been drunk from it, Elijah had been present. And Elijah's job was to herald in the coming Messiah, was to bring about the fulfillment of Jewish prophecy. Jesus was bold enough not just to go back and check the cup, but he took the cup. Lifting it and giving God honor and thanks, he blessed it
And then he perhaps did one of the most blasphemous things that he could ever have done. He told the disciples to drink from it, holding in not only his claim to be Messiah, but letting us know that we too were part of that history, that we were the living Messiah here in the world. No longer a God who is out there, but a God who is in here. He said to his disciples, take and drink of this. Drink fully and deeply and feel the presence of love moving through your body. For when you do this, you remember me. Now remember, he didn't mean just cast a memory, to then become my name, so that we might be the hands and feet and heart and life of Christ in the world today. And those are values that we can share whether we are Christians or followers of Jesus, or Jewish or Muslim or Buddhist, or of no other specific religion but the religion of self and of good promise in this world. As a progressive community of faith, that's who we believe we are. We believe that we are manifesting goodness and wholeness, first in our lives, and then, like Jesus' love, it spills out on everybody else. So know that in this meal today, this open bread and this shared cup, it is a symbol for us all to come together in unity and in love. Would you pray?